we wanted something fun.
Right.
Jason was all about uptown funk.
Sure.
Like, yes.
You know,
it's,
I can
like,
see
the,
that.
The dancing. What we did not want was to do something that 10, 15, 20 years from now, we would look back and say, why did we choose that? Just because it was the it song
right.
of that time.
Yeah.
But it was just, you know, music, it just sets the mood for the rest of
absolutely.
For the celebration.
Sure.
So it's really important.
Songs that I just, like, drive me crazy. Celebration is one of those songs that, you know, first of all, it probably gets in your head and you can't stop singing it. But
yes.
it's also one of those overplayed songs at every single wedding. Old Time Rock and Roll, Bob Seger. I've got a list of them. So that one's another one which just drives me crazy. I can't stand that one either. Now, I'm sure a lot of the ones that are really going to get played all the time now, obviously, like we said, Ed Sheeran is a big one. He is so popular with
yes.
so many people and so good.
He's really good. And not just that one song, but all of his songs.
All of his songs.
You can listen to his soundtrack and think, that's what I want. That's what I want. Actually, one of the things that really helped Jason and I,
yep.
Because it was supposed to be his thing during the wedding planning.
Oh, there you go. Wait a second. How long have you been married?
2 months.
Okay. Did you see that? She tapped me on the thing. It was supposed to be, and then she did the air quotes, and I rolled. Man, you got this nailed in 2 months.
I know, yeah.
Ready? So give me a little high five. There we go. Atta girl. There you go.
But he was supposed to be in charge of the music,
right.
but we ended up actually working as a team, which is what we typically do.
Right.
Like Gwink, honey. And we found that Shazam was really helpful.
Oh, yeah.
Every time we were in the car, we just, whenever we heard a song, whether it was an oldies or a new song, we would just Shazam it, and then that's how we made our list.
Right.
And we actually included almost everything we wanted.
That's really good. And anybody who doesn't know what Shazam is, it's an app you can just download on your phone. You push the button, and it'll find what the song is, and then kind of compiles the list
exactly.
for you. That's a great idea for anyone out there who's, you know, actually a lot of DJs out there probably going, thank God, because I'm sure brides and everything else come to them and say, well, I want that song, and then they start humming it, and they have no
clue.
They have no clue what it is, or they're completely off key and everything else. So it's nice to have something like that.
It is.
Yes. So that works out. Great advice from a lady who just got married. All good stuff. All right, we're going to go over to our mix master.
Thank you.
Brendan Kirby.
Just throwing it down.
He is on the ones and twos.
Oh, you know it.
Mixing it up.
And the threes. Is that even a thing? I tell you what I could do. If I never hear Journey's Don't Stop Believing Again, it's over for that. And also, it doesn't matter what event I'm at, wedding or not, I am requesting Power of Love by Huey Lewis and the News.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
One of the finest songs ever in the history of music. Well, cue up your pieces of vinyl. Let's see what our friends on social media have to say about what they enjoy and dislike when it comes to wedding tunes. Jamie Coelho was up first, sharing some of her favorites. Take Me Home Tonight. Don't Stop Believing,
Wait.
No.
take Me Home Tonight. I love that. Eddie Money.
I do like that one. 80s music is always the best. Valerie Gilbert. Randall Gendron is
up. I may
up.
Know her.
I don't know how this happened. I'm glad it did. She's up next with a song she reviles. There it is. I never want to hear that stupid chicken dance. I agree there.
Why
and lastly,
would you want to start off your marriage that way? You chicken dance.
I suspect foul play.
Yes,
sorry, I had to do it. And lastly, Lynn Jackson Rossier shares one of her favorites, You and I by Crystal Gayle and Eddie Rabbit.
Hello, 1970.
It's very sweet. Thanks for commenting this morning, everybody. We'll try.